Thank you very much, sir. Each of the times that any of my three sons were born, and they were all about 3 weeks early, and I was always surprised at how little they were. I mean, each time anew, I was surprised at how small they were, and it was very evident how in need of support and protection and caring for they were. And of course, it not just my newborns who are in need of that kind of protection and caring. Every baby born in this country is worthy of that kind of proper medical care and of protection. Protecting newborn babies is unequivocally the right thing to do, and more than three quarters of Americans agree that infants that are born alive, survivors, should be given the same medical treatment as any other newborn. And we've talked so much today, as well as yesterday, about this bill, the majority's higher education authorization. It would send billions of dollars to colleges and universities, but I think we want to make sure that we're sending those dollars to colleges and universities that honor the dignity of all people. And we talked a lot today and yesterday about the power to provide opportunity to grow and become the best version of ourselves. And that kind of opportunity should extend to all people, including those who are victims of an abortion that is unsuccessful. And so I urge my colleagues to provide the same type of medical treatment to college, to these children who happen to be born alive at college or university health centers. There are many of them across our country. They play a key role in providing quality medical care, and I think they should play a key role in providing quality medical care to those who are born alive as well. I would ask for support of the amendment, and Mr. Chairman, I would yield back.